Cyril, save, and recompile my presentations. And when the compilation will be done, the presentation will change. You will see it soon. But we can also use static websites. Pillar don't do that, but an application was made on top of Pillar. This application is ecstatic. So, for example, you may want to write an HTML page with Pillar, like this, and you can have your HTML generated. So, ecstatic was created by Guillermo Polito and Stefan Picasso. So you can generate your website. You have many templates, so you have default templates. You choose the one you want. But if you don't find the template you want, you can create your own. So for example, we use ecstatic now to for the website of ecstatic, or for the website of DBXTalk. Esteban talked about DBXTalk earlier on today. Or you can also create your personal page with ecstatic. So for example, a member of the Hermon team, Martin Diaz, created his own personal page with ecstatic. So you can find more at this address. And finally, we have a prototype of documentation renderer made by Castor Osterwald. So we want in Pharo to have to write Pillar on a place documentation, and we want Pharo to render it nice. So Castor made a prototype where we can write, for example, a header or a list, and Pharo will render this. So now I will explain a little how to begin a documentation with Pillar. So it's simple to begin. You can download a script. The script is available on GitHub, available on GitHub. This script will download your Pillar image on Pharo. It will make some script. And you can just write a file with, for example, hello world, and export it with a simple command line. So I will show you a little here. So I already downloaded the script because I was not sure I had a connection here. I can create my new document. So for example, first.pillar. On this document, I can write a header, a sub-header. I can write, if I want, a list. Download the script. You say that you want to export it. You say the format you want, so for example, HTML. You can give a name of your output file. So output file, I want first.html. And I say I want to export first.pylab. And now you have your HTML page. So yeah, or not.
Present a little how works Pylab.
So at the beginning, you write your pillar file. Then pillar will get your configuration. So if you made a configuration, it will create it will read the pillar.conf file. Or if you didn't make one, pillar has a default configuration. And after that, pillar will get the file you want to export and parse it to create a document model. So the document model is a tree. You have the root, PR document, and the PR document have such some children which are document items. And each document item can have its own children. So for example, when you have this in your file, Pillar will create a PR document with a header. The header will have some text, so for example, if you put exclamation point hello world, the header will have as children a PR text and the child a PR text that contains hello world. You can also have some paragraphs that contain, for example, text or a script or figure. And when you have your document, you may want to transform it. So let's take an example. You write a document and you want to export it in HTML. We don't have a syntax to add a section structure on a pillar file, but you want a section structure to adapt the form of your file or your HTML file. So you can use a section transformer. This will visit your document and this will change some node of your document model. So for example, to add a PR section. And when your transformation is done, you just export it. So we have some writers. So the writers will take the document model and export it in a file. And sometimes you can want to have some post-export phase. So for example, if you have a .tech file, you may want to use PDF LaTeX to have a PDF. So the export in Pillar is divided on a phase. So we have a phase that will get the collection of input files. We have a phase that will parse the files. We have a phase that will transform the file, and then we have a phase that will export the files. With Pillar, we wanted to have some simple, an easy syntax to write easily some documentation, but we wanted more. We wanted Pillar to be easy to extend, because we can cover all the needs. And we wanted to have a good architecture to allow you to do what you want with Pillar. So for example, it's easy to add an exporter. An exporter will just write a document model, and your document model is a tree. We already have a visitor that will visit the tree, and you can just make a subclass of a writer, and you just say, oh, I have a visitor that will visit the table node. So I override this visitor to say, for example, in HTML, if I have a table node, I want a table tag in HTML. So the table tag will contain the visit of the children of the table. So it's easy to add an exporter, and we have a lot of tests to help you. You just have to override some requirement on the test. You say, when I have a table, I expect that in the result. And so you have a lot of tests to help you. You can also, sometimes you need more syntax. You may want to add something, but if you add, you take the risk that you will break existing document if you add syntax. So we added the annotations that are syntax extension points. An annotation is something that has a tag and may have parameters. So the parameters are described with magrid. For example, you can have the input file tag annotation. So if you want inside a pillar document add include another pillar document, you can use this annotation, the tag is input file, and you can add a parameter, the path of your document. Or in a slide, if you want to say here I want the beginning of a slide, you can have a slide tag on an annotation et have a parameter title, the title of your slide. This annotation works really well with the transformer and it's really easy to create one. So for example, if you want to create one, you just have to create a subclass of pair abstract annotation. In this subclass, you have to say the tag of my annotation will be this. So you create your tag. And if you want to use some parameter, you just have to create an instance method with a magrid description. So for example, I may want to have a parameter with a number, so I can say I want a parameter. Its key will be width. It's required, and the user can't use this annotation without this parameter. And the parameter has to be between 0 or 100. And you might be able to check that during the pass that the description match. And as I said, you can use transformers, and we wanted that to be easy to use too. So a transformer which is just visit your document and transform some nodes so you can delete some nodes and add one. So we created some basic structure to transform a document. So for example, we have a structure that will help you if you want to just remove a node and replace it with a new node. Or we have a transformer structure to help you if you want to have some nodes that will go on a new node. So for example, in a section transformer, you have some children of a document that need to go on a peer section node. So for example, for the file inclusion, when I have my annotation input file, I use a transformer. So this is a subclass of peer node transformer that will transform the annotation node to the new document model. So you create a subclass, and you just create or override a visit method. So I say I parse my file and I replace my annotation node by the document I get by the parse. Your transformer can have some priority. So for example, when you include a file into the document model, you want it to be transformed by the next transformer. So you want the input file to be one of the first transformer that will be applied. So I can define a priority here, 1, to say this will be one of the first priority. If a transformer is not, don't really need other transformers, you will put a high priority to let space to other transformers to be included later. And one thing too, you can add directly some documentations into your method, and you will be able to use that later to generate the documentations of your transformer. So you don't have to rewrite this transformer, do that every time you add one, you just do a comment on your method. And you can add also a keyword, and this keyword will allow to disable a transformer if you want. So if I don't want the section to be added on an HTML export, I will just say on the configuration, I will just add file inclusion, this keyword, section, this keyword, and that this will disable the transformer. So, in conclusion, we wanted Pillar to be to write easily some documentation. So you write one file with a simple syntax. You have many inputs. We wanted it easy to extend. For example, someone wanted to generate his website, personal website, on the Airbot team. But he had a lot of papers, and he didn't want it to add each paper by hand, so he just made an annotation where he put in parameters a bib file and the transformer. This transformer will remove the annotation of the pillar tree and generate automatically the list of his publications. So in future work, we want to improve the Pharo renderer, so to add class documentation with Pillar. We want to add an EPUB and a DocBook exporter. And we have still a large to-do list. So I know that Pillar worked one time on gemstone and Squeak. I don't know if they still works on them, but we can help you if you want to adapt Pillar to gemstone and Squeak or other small talk. But we ask one thing, that if you create a continuous integration to help to maintain Pillar. So as I said, we have a large to-do list, so if you want to help you, you're welcome. So, do you have any question?
I would like to ask the presentation. It goes through the Beamer.
Yeah.
Could you show us some example of the Beamer template? How does it look like?
So, okay. So the file I generated was that. So I have my template here, and Pillar generated this.
And the source code for my thing was handled by Beamer or Pillar?
Pillar.
Thank you.
Any other question? Thank you very much.
So we will wait to offer them the gift that they can provide this year. we should probably wait a bit that the other session finishes before starting. I need one student volunteer. Can you go to the other room for a bit? If they just you tell them that we finished and that we are waiting for them for the or if they quickly included the agenda that we start with of them. Thank you.